I personally, in my district, have numerous blue ribbon schools, so the education system in Philadelphia is certainly working, considering we have the highest poverty congressional district in the entire country located in Philadelphia. There needs to be more support. There are areas that have trouble, have socioeconomic issues, have language barriers, and we certainly have plenty of first-generation citizens. So while we take all these things into account as we're educating our children in Philadelphia, we also have the charter schools. Could you talk about the proficiency of and the goal meeting of the cyber charters?
Growth on their academics is something that is a metric that all of our schools that are designated work on. But if they were designated for graduation, low graduation rate, then that's certainly one of their targets and they're one of the goals that they need to work on.
So we're having these issues, and let's publicly state here, their reimbursement per student is the same amount per student per school district of any brick and mortar, and their proficiencies are challenged, even with all the money they're receiving without having to maintain a brick and mortar school for the children to attend, correct?
That would be correct.
Okay, so they got in all that money and we're not meeting the benchmarks is what we're saying. Thank you very much. I'm not necessarily anti-charter. I certainly think that a law that hasn't been revised or touched upon in 20 years needs to be revisited.